Okay, let's do some math for fun. Here I have a very interesting question for you guys. Is it possible to have 1 to some power and the result is equal to 2? What do you guys think? Well, let me tell you, if you enter this on Wolfram Alpha, you will see right here, it shows no solution. And it doesn't even give you any complex solution for this. That's really bizarre, right? So maybe, okay, that's the end of the video, but no, of course not. Let's still try to solve it and let's try to investigate if we can actually get some answer, maybe from the complex world that the Wolfram Alpha couldn't. So let's just give it a try, yeah? And the result is going to be pretty interesting, so you just have a look. Anyway, I'm going to write this down again, 1 to the x power, and this is equal to 2. Well, by the look of it, it's like an exponential function because the x is in the exponent. So I would like to take logarithm, and then the logarithm that I'm going to use is just log base 1. It's the best one that we can use right here because they cancel out. Alright, anyway though. The left hand side, we will just get x by itself, and then on the right hand side, I will use the change of base formula, which will be ln 2 over ln 1. And now, you might see it, yes, ln 1 is 0, so we have ln 2 over 0, that's not defined. So maybe, I just really cannot get a solution for this. But you know what, don't give up. All we have to do is bring the 1 to the complex world and maybe make it into its complex form. Maybe you can continue much better. So have a look. Right here, let me do it on the side for you guys. 1 on the complex plane is going to be right here. And I want to change that to its complex form. We need two things. The first thing is the distance from the origin to here, which is just equal to 1. And then the next thing that we need is to erase the equal sign better. And then the third thing that we need is the angle from here to here, which is just going to be 0. So let me just indicate that theta is equal to 0. All right, cool. Now, here we have ln 2 over, here we have ln 1. Put that into its polar form, we need rei theta. R is 1, so we just have e raised to the I, and the theta is equal to 0. If I cancel the ln and e, I get I 0. I'm still dividing by 0. Man. But you know what? This 0 is not the only angle that will end up right here in this direction. Because if you really want to do some rotation, of course you can. Starting from here, you can rotate 360 degrees. But we're adults now, so say that as 2 pi. And if you would like, you can do the reverse, negative 2 pi. And if you really like, you can do 2 loops, which is 4 pi, etc, etc. So the truth is, you have infinitely many angles can end up in this direction, and we really have to write down the whole thing. So the whole thing is just actually multiple of 2 pi. So we'll just plus 2 pi n, where n is just an integer. It can be positive or negative whole number. So, we will actually have to attach that right here as well. So I will just add 2 pi n, right? That's actually our theta. We have to look at its all of its value because we have multi value for this situation. Now we can cancel this out and we don't really have to have a 0 on the bottom anymore. And then what do we have is just going to be ln 2 on the top. And then we have I, and just that, so I'll just write it as I times 2 pi n. But you know me, I don't like to be on the bottom, I like to be on the top. So let's multiply the bottom and the top by I. So that this right here will be negative 1. So all in all, I will write this as negative 1 on the top with the I, and then ln 2. Over 2 pi n, or 2 n pi, depending on how you want to write it. And before I box this, you see the n is on the bottom, right? So you have to make sure that n cannot be equal to 0. N cannot be equal to 0, just like that. Now, How many solutions do we actually have? Well, it's kind of like infinitely many, but each every time you put the answer, let's say you choose n to be 1, if you put it back, let me just show you how it looks like, yeah? So let's say we take n to be 1, so we just have this guy, right? So what we get is just 1 to the power of negative I ln 2 over 2 pi. Will this give us 2? The answer to this is yes, but not all the time. And the reason is because if you really want to do the complex analysis, when you do 1 to this power, you have to write 1 in terms of its polar form. And then you have infinitely many answers for that, right? And then you have to work out some exponents business. Yeah, and you have infinitely many answers. And one of the answers will be 2. It's a very weird computation, right? So hopefully you get okay with that. But before we end, I would like to talk about, you see, 1 to the x power is equal to 2. On Wolfram alpha, it does not give you any solution. However, if you look at 1 to the x power is equal to 2 as 1 equals 2 to the 1 over x power, namely just take the x root on both sides. If you enter this on the Wolfram alpha, it actually works. Pretty interesting. I think it's just because how they compute 1 to some power is just always 1 because x is like a real number. So that's pretty much why I think. I really don't know, but once you enter this, you will see that it will actually give you an answer like that, right? Of course, n cannot be equal to 0, then we give you that answer. Really cool, right? So, hopefully, you guys all like this video. And as always, that's it.